Welcome back. Okay, let's talk about the part of our bodies that we mostly ignore. The part that we shove into stilettos and we lace up in leather, we slide into sandals and cover with nylon, wool, and cotton. The part we can't see when we're pregnant, yeah, our feet. Well, here to keep us on our toes is Dr. Crystal Holmes from APMA. Hi, Dr. Holmes.
Hi, Niki.
Now, Dr. Holmes, what exactly is APMA?
The APMA is the American Podiatric Medical Association, which is the nation's leading professional organization for foot doctors or podiatrists. The APMA.org is the nation's leading website for foot information.
So Dr. Holmes, podiatrists are especially concerned about our feet, right?
That's absolutely right. Podiatrists are concerned with all foot and ankle conditions. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, most Americans will have pain at some point in their life, and many believe that pain is normal.
Well, isn't it? I would think some pain's normal.
Well, pain is not normal. And if you're experiencing pain, that's definitely a great reason to see a podiatrist. Our feet do undergo a lot of stress. In fact, regular walking can result in pressures that are equal to several tons.
Wow, tons. Okay, so how do we take some of this pressure off our poor old feet?
Well, there's some really simple things that you can do to take better care of your feet. First, make sure that each time you bathe, that you're washing your feet thoroughly, you're drying them well, and you're checking them for signs of change.
All right, change. What kind of change are we looking for?
Well, change can mean cuts, it can mean scrapes, discoloration. If there is pain that persists, all of these things would be a great reason for you to go to the website, APMA.org, or for you to contact your local podiatrist.
All right, that sounds serious.
Your feet can be a great indicator of more serious conditions, such as diabetes, circulatory disorders, arthritic conditions, such as gout.
So our feet can tell a lot about our overall health.
Absolutely. Yeah. Your feet can be a great window for other conditions that are more serious. Mm-hmm. You can have hereditary conditions, such as bone abnormalities, like bunions and hammer toes.
Ooh.
If you have shoes that are poorly made and not constructed well, that can be a shoe that's unsupportive. That can lead to conditions that could damage your tendons, your ligaments, your bones.
So I love each and every pair of my shoes. Are you telling us that our shoes could be affecting the health of our feet?
Absolutely.
Tell us what to look for when we're choosing a shoe or a stiletto.
So you want to make sure that the shoe, again, is well made, it's offering arch supports, that the toe box is big enough to accommodate the toes. That's the major problem with stilettos. Also, the shoe should fit your activity. So whatever you're going to be doing in the shoe, you want to make sure that it's comfortable. And if you're having an issue with moisture, that you're rotating your socks frequently.
Moisture? Okay, so why is keeping our feet dry so important?
Well, it's important because moisture is a breeding ground for microbes, such as bacteria, fungus, viruses. So if you have an environment with a lot of moisture, that could lead to a condition like athlete's foot, which is fungus.
So athlete's foot, what are the signs that we should be looking for?
If you have skin that's red, irritated, scaly, peeling, itching, blistering, all of those conditions could be a sign of athlete's foot. But athlete's foot is not the only foot infection.
Right.
So if it's worsening, if it's persisting, if you're experiencing pain, you should definitely seek medical attention.
So can I take care of some of these problems by myself?
Well, you want to remember that a minor problem can become a major problem. So if you have any questions about foot conditions, again, you can go to APMA.org for simple answers. And you can also use APMA.org to find a podiatrist in your area.
All right, so what about walking barefoot at home or on the beach? Is that a problem?
Well, walking barefoot can provide you a lot of physical and psychological benefits, but you should never walk barefoot in an environment that's dirty or littered. This can result in cuts, scrapes, and again, cause a bacterial infection. I always recommend, though, that you use a well-constructed sandal if you're going to be out in the environment, and use sunscreen. And don't forget to apply the sunscreen to your feet.
So sunscreen on our feet.
Yes.
I know, I have done that before and my feet are red and everything else is tan. And I have always, I wear slippers everywhere. So, wear slippers at work.
That's a great practice. It keeps your feet nice and comfortable and you're not experiencing foot pain.
Well, you have told us so many amazing vital things about our feet and for our health. Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back with more on Having It All.